My name is Katie Hamler, Indian Extension Horticulture Specialist, and I'm going to talk about some insects. So the first one is kind of uncommon in Missouri. These are on windblown storms. There's not any weather here, but can do some significant damage, which we saw last year. So this is Mellonworm. It has shooting mouthparts, and you can see the shooting damage that it did on the pumpkin stem on the left. It can also do damage to the fruit itself, and then it found some on blossom last year. This is a squash beetle, another uncommon one that we have seen increasing in populations in the last few years. It's a little bigger than ladybug size, but does have spots, orange background color, and does chewing damage, whether that's from the adults, like in this leaf, or these are the juveniles that are typically found underneath pumpkin leaves. This one is the most common problem, and this is squash bug. And so if you see yellowing leaves or brown spots on the leaves, if you flip those over, most likely you are going to see those squash bugs. They have piercing, sucking mouth parts, and they suck out the plant pieces and can be devastating in a pumpkin patch. So you can see the all the juveniles, they gradually get bigger and smaller, which is much easier to control than larger. The other common one that we see is cucumber beetles. So on the left, we have the striped version, and on the right, we have the spotted version. Both can do damage from chewing themselves, and then the striped version can also carry bacterial wilt, which is a disease problem that we can experience. Typically, I see more of the spotted than the striped, but this year I saw lots of striped also. Now, this one is a bad one. If you see a vine wilting and notice a hole in the bottom, it could be from the adult. Is the squash vine borer moth, and it lays its eggs, and then those larvae bore into the stem and disrupt the plant processes. And the other common insects for our pumpkins and squash are bees. Bees are essential for pollination because anything in the cucurbit family has male and female blossoms are separate. So in the picture on the left, you can see that female blossom that has that fruit right under it. The male blossom goes directly to a stem. So those pollinators are extremely important. So you can see a bumblebee, and the one on the right is actually a squash bee. But notice on that flower, you also see a cucumber beetle and a squash beetle. So we can have our pest insects along with our beneficial insects. So keep that in mind. Then here we can see some of the pollination work playing out the bumblebee. And in this case, a squash bee was flying in. Honeybees also do lots of pollination on squash. And both of these happen to be male flowers as opposed to female flowers right now. So that makes it extremely important to look and make sure that those squash blossoms are closed like they are in this case. So spraying for it, those pest insects in the evening so we protect those pollinators. Also important to get any others underneath those leaves because as you saw earlier, a lot of those pesky insects do like to hide under the leaves. So those are just a few common insects of pumpkins. And if you have any questions, please feel free to contact your local NU Extension Horticulture Specialist. Thank you.